Aishoeb, thank you so much for taking the time to sit with me today.
Thank you for the opportunity to talk about the brain knowledge platform. If we are able to achieve our goal, we can understand how the brain works and the structure of brain. So we are trying to build a single platform to achieve all these goals. And it's just not the Allen Institute, but the entire neuroscience community.
You know, as the science is evolving, the data is evolving. So what are some strategies in terms of managing that data as well as knowledge base?
We are dealing with a very large, vast amount of data. We have close to 80 to 100 petabytes. We assume that it will go to the exabytes level in not a distant future. The key challenge is that all these data at times are not similar to each other. There's a lot of modalities in brain. We are investing a lot on the automation side of data integration to validate the data coming in and make sure that our data models are very flexible. Also, what's the best way to search that data? So we have invested in our visualization tool, which are very, very flexible.
It certainly sounds like having modular data architecture and flexibility is really important for the brain knowledge platform. Will you tell me a little bit more about the applications of AIML?
You know, there's opportunities that we can provide a natural language interface because not all our users are really adept computer programmers, and machine learning and AI is really helping us to find the connections between this data set, which are different from each other, but has a missing piece of information that's useful to complete the big picture.
It certainly sounds like the analytics layer using AI and machine learning is also very critical for BKP.
Absolutely.
It was amazing talking with you, Shoaib. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Jenna.